Good afternoon, student. I am OV Ashish Kamle, the Assistant Professor of Electronics from Computer Science Department. Welcome to our e-learning platform. In a previous video, we discussed short-range wireless technology, that means Bluetooth, ZigBee, Z-Wave, RFID. In this video, we discuss location tracking system, that means GPS. In this video, we discuss some points about a GPS, what is GPS, how it works, component of GPS, GPS receiver, and application of GPS. First, what is the GPS? GPS is Global Positioning System, which is a global navigation system, satellite system that provides location, velocity, and time synchronization at various locations on the Earth. GPS is a satellite-based navigation system. It is used as a digital signal at about 1.5 GHz from each satellite to send data to the receiver. GPS is worldwide radio navigation system formed for the constellation of 24 satellites and their ground station. The system, which was initially designed for the operation of US military, but today there are also many civil users of GPS across the whole world. Next is how it works. GPS requires the use of many satellites orbiting the Earth. These satellites continuously broadcast their location and status above us. This is continuously monitored by the GPS master control station as well as other tracking and monitoring stations here on the ground to ensure accuracy and proper function. The master control station is also responsible for maintenance and correction should anything go wrong. A GPS device on Earth receives this signal, interpreting each one unique data. By mapping the location of four or more satellites in a relation to the tracking device, it can triangulate its exact position in a three-dimensional space. Next is component of GPS. The technical and operational characteristics of GPS are organized into three distinct segments. First, space segment. Second, operational control segment, and third, user equipment segment. Let's discuss one by one. First, space segment. The GPS space segment consists of constellation of satellite transmitting radio signals to the user. Second, operational control segment. The GPS operational control segment consists of the master control station located at Falcon Air Force Base in Colorado Springs and uplink antennas located at three of four remote monitoring stations at the MCS, that is master control stations. Third is user equipment segment. The GPS user equipment varies widely in cost and complexity depending on the receiver design and applications. Next is GPS receiver. It is a very important part of GPS system. The GPS receiver is a L-band radio processor capable of solving the navigation equation in order to determine the user position, velocity, and precise time, that is PVT, by processing the signal broadcasted by GPS satellite. Using suitable software, the device may display the position on a map, and it may offer routing directions. A GPS receiver set provides only basic positioning information to complex multi-channel unit that tracks all satellites in a view and perform a variety of functions. For more tracking information, user has to subscribe the services. Most GPS receiver consist of three basic components. First, antenna. Second, receiver. And third, control or display unit. Let's discuss one by one. First, antenna. An antenna which receives the signals. It is called antenna. Receiver, a processor unit which convert radio signal to usable navigation solution. And third one is control or display unit, which display the positioning information and provides the interface for receiver control. Next, application of GPS. In a GPS used in agriculture, in aviation, in environment, in marine, section and in public safety and disaster relief, and it also used in railway section also. Thank you. Keep watching my video.